So, why did you decide to run?
Well, I tell you, we have some issues with our sheriff's office and specifically our sheriff that I think needed to be addressed. And every 4 years, we get a chance to call our elected officials on the carpet and give the voters a chance to make a selection and change if they think they deserve it. And I think they need to make a change this time.
As far as the things that you are concerned about, or things that you think are not up to par, if you will, with the current sheriff, what are some of those things you feel are not up to par?
Well, I think our current administration lacks fiscal responsibility. We've had a increase in our budget of almost $38 million. And, we have given our deputies and our employees raises, but not $38 million worth. We waste money, and I think the excessive spending needs to be brought under control. And we would know that if we had transparency. And right now, we don't have transparency, such as the our county has lost their voice. You in Jacksonville, you cover the news up there, and when it's really big, you'll come to St. Johns County and cover it like you are. And thank you for covering our race. But we've lost our voice because we don't have a local news station. We don't have a local newspaper anymore. And we go to social media. And when the sheriff turns off the comments where we can't engage with our sheriff's office, the citizens don't know what's going on. So all they get is a positive message. They don't really know what's going on. And I think that's wrong. It's not very transparent.
So, if you became sheriff, how would you change that in contrast to what the current sheriff is doing now?
Well, for 6 years, I actually was in charge of our social media and our media back when Chuck Mulligan was still running, doing our interviews and on-camera work. I was there running all of the other functions of the office of the sheriff. And social media was one of those things that I was in charge of. We actually hired a social media person from Channel 4, the local station. We hired her, and she brought our followership from around 19,000 to over 60,000. And in the process, we became engaged with our public, and then we got some of the best information. And that's how you become transparent, when you can communicate and you have to put out the good with the bad. You can't just put out all good. You have to be transparent. The public wants to know what's not always good. You have to give them the whole story.
So I spoke with the sheriff just as I'm interviewing you now, and he said that he feels that one of his accomplishments is the fact that he has gotten crime down by 10%, that there's been an improvement there. What do you have to say to that?
Well, I say that's false. That is a political answer. I'm a fourth generation cop, not a politician. And I can tell you, being in law enforcement, serving the citizens and visitors of St. Johns County for the last 27 years at this one agency, we have a problem. Well, crime is on the rise, and we're not doing anything to address it. We want to tell everybody everything's okay. Well, it's not. I had a public records request, and I confirmed what the ad says, a 51% increase. I pulled the records and I confirmed it. And we do have a crime problem. And those are the things that need to be addressed. It's not all sunshines and butterflies.
And so, day one, if you become sheriff, what would you change? What would you keep?
Well, of course, I don't want to come in and everybody's scared to death of change. Everybody wants it, but when it comes, everybody's really nervous. I would want to make the impact of the transition between the old administration and my administration as smooth as possible so that the workers, the workforce, can keep doing the positive job that they're doing. I want to make a change to where I can do an audit on the budget to find out where we are. We have some spending problems, and we've got to get those under control. We have some lawsuits that are pending right now. We have eight pending lawsuits right now for deputies getting involved in crashes. And we don't even offer our deputies driver training. Those are problems that we have to get under control. And once I can get that under control, I will build a team of leaders in the agency and then start putting the policies back in place that we have changed to allow the encourage the culture that has become what it is now.
And so, for you, do you believe there's anything that's being done right now at the sheriff's office, as opposed to the things that you believe should change?
Absolutely. The men and women that are out there risking their lives, that are in there taking the 911 calls, that are watching over the care, custody, and control of our inmates, all of our office staff, every unit that is at that sheriff's office. And when you hear the verbiage of it takes a village, well, this entire agency of almost 1,000 employees is doing a great job. We just need a leader that will, our leader, our alleged leader of the sheriff's office, has spent the last 4 years running for office instead of running the office. And that's where, when I get elected, I'm going to spend my time working at the sheriff's office, not driving to a bunch of parties and everything like that. I'm going to be involved in the community, but the agency comes first. I need to be going to the insurance committee meetings to make sure I can try to lower the insurance rate for our county employees. Those are the things that we need to be having a leader do for our agency. That's what I would do.
Yes, sir. And so you've been working in law enforcement for a very long time. Talk about your history in law enforcement and why you chose to be in law enforcement in the first place.
Well, I was raised by a cop that was raised by a cop that was raised by a cop, 4 generations. I was proud to raise my hand with Sheriff Perry raised when he invited me in and allowed me to become the fourth generation in my family to serve in law enforcement. And one of the things that happened in that meeting is he you had a meeting with the sheriff, and in that meeting, he told you exactly what he expected you to do. And if you didn't do that, he told you exactly what you could expect to happen. And if you didn't follow the rules or the policies, you didn't work there anymore. We have lost that. Our sheriff doesn't even meet with the people we hire. When I got into law enforcement, I did it because I wanted to help people. And I have enjoyed serving honorably for the last 27 years. Over half of my life, I've been at this one agency serving the people. I have met many people and have been through some horrific, but yet joyous occasions at this sheriff's office. And the men and women I've served with couldn't find a better group of people in the world. And I am running because they need a voice. They need someone to stick up for them, to advocate for them. They need someone. And like when you have a retiree, someone getting ready to retire, and the CEO doesn't take their retirement papers because that you might run against them and tries to intimidate you out of the race, that's not right. And that's what happened to me. And that's why I wanted to stick up for our agency members and do the right thing for them.
And I was going to ask you, what has been the reaction? You're still there. So what has been the reaction to you running, against your commander in chief, if you will?
Well, I had to retire in order to run. He denied accepting my retirement paperwork back in January, and he basically threatened the Constitution, which he was trying to insinuate the resign to run law, which means you have to resign 10 days before the qualifying date, which was in June. But at the time he was threatening that, I wasn't even a declared candidate, and neither was he. It was in December of 23. And for him to try to intimidate me from running then was the first step. And then 2 weeks, or this coming Friday will be 2 weeks, but on August 9th, I received a letter that said he was going to criminally charge me for using a picture in my uniform on my campaign materials. And now he's trying to criminally charge me and intimidate me out of this race. And that's just not right. For him to abuse his power like that is absolutely not right.
Okay. And in contrast, he has said that he hasn't ran any like bad ads about you or anything of that nature, but you're saying behind the scenes there is something else that's happening.
Absolutely. There was an article in Florida Politics. I think it came out last Friday, this past Friday, it came out, and it outlines pretty much everything that has happened. Some people say it's lies. I can show you the proof where he texted me that night when he refused to take my retirement letter. I can show you the cease and desist letter where he said he would use any and all legal means as a first degree misdemeanor threat to keep me from using all of that. He basically wanted me to stop all of my campaigning with my picture on it to try to hurt my chances of campaigning against him. And that's wrong for him to try to intimidate me, use the law against me to try in a political way. And for his attorney, the attorney of the sheriff's office, to do that was also wrong, and it's possibly an elections violation.
And do you plan on pursuing the potential election violation at this point, or are you going to
Absolutely.
wait till after to see what happens on tomorrow?
Absolutely. Somebody asked me, it's like, hey, what are you going to do if you lose? I'm like, well, you know what? I've already won because I don't have to work for him anymore. That environment is not a good environment. I see all these people, commenting on Facebook that says, he's a great guy. Well, they've probably never worked for him. And I'm glad that I don't have to work in that environment, but I felt strong enough about running to look out for the people that still do. They deserve better. The people of our county deserve a better acting sheriff than what we have now. And the reason they don't know is because he controls the narrative by not being able, letting people engage on social media.
So, day one, if you are elected as sheriff, what's your first goal day one?
The first goal is to try to set everybody's mind at ease that I'm there to do a job to make sure they know the culture is going to change. I am open to suggestions. I want to create workforce meetings at three different levels, the line level, supervisor level, and the manager level, and have them give me input on how we want to run this agency. I will be open to ideas from internal. They are the ones doing the job. They have the best ideas. I will be open to those. Nothing will be off of the table. There are deputies that we actually, when I before I left, and we had a proposal for two permanent shifts and two rotating shifts. And some of the command staff didn't like that idea, so it was shot down. And we had an 88% agreeing rate with all of the deputies in patrol, which to get that many deputies to agree on anything is just great. But it was just it was heartbreaking to see all of the work that they put into that project and it just be pushed to the side. That's something that the men and women could, could count on. I can say I could be on days for a year. I can plan my life. I can see how it affects my lifestyle at home. Rotating shifts is not good for your health. On nights, you go 3 months on days. The 2 weeks before and the 2 weeks after are the when you have the most crashes because your body's trying to adjust. Those kinds of things, your crash rates go up. All of these things were done and studied, and that's why we were trying to reduce the amount of shift. Didn't get it done because they didn't like it. Those kinds of things are what I would implement. The deputies want to, we're going to do it. If it doesn't work, we'll try something different. But anything that can save us money, that's what I want to do.
Also, when I spoke with the current sheriff, he mentioned to me that there are plans in place because the population of St. John's County is going to continue to grow. What would you do as the population continues to grow in that county to make sure that crime rates don't increase?
Well, one thing we haven't done since he's been the sheriff, we haven't done any kind of workload assessment studies, manpower allocation studies. We haven't done any of that. How do we even know that we're using our manpower the right way? I would do both of those to make sure we're using our manpower in the right way. We may need a different shift system to make sure that we have the manpower out when we need it and not wasting man hours in the middle of the night when we don't need it. Those are the kinds of things that we haven't done and we need to do, not just keep asking for more bodies in the budget process. We need to know what we're asking for and why we're asking for it. And those are two things that we haven't done since he's been the sheriff.
And I asked the sheriff this question in his current position. What has been the most difficult day as sheriff, and what has been his greatest, most memorable, happy day of sheriff? So I'll ask you, in your career in law enforcement, what has been your most difficult day, and what has been your happiest, greatest day?
Well, I think my most difficult day is when is when you have to lay a brother officer down. Those are pretty difficult. And the happiest days, there are a bunch of them, but anytime you can help save a life, I was able to do that with a fellow deputy sheriff. We were on a dive operation and his dive gear malfunctioned, and I was able to bring him up and save his life. So that was a pretty happy day for me. But you know, there's so many happy days of being able to see six different kids that were in the Explore program become deputy sheriffs at our agency that I helped along the way, was a small part of their lives. That's a great day. Seeing a kid that came from a troubled background, help me along this journey and donate money and help me get people behind me and support behind me on this journey to be sheriff. Those are the kind of things that are a happy day for me.
Is there anything else you want the public to know, as far as the reason behind your running, anything at all that you would want voters to know when they go to the polls for Tuesday?
Well, I am, like I said, a fourth generation law enforcement officer, not a politician. I am going to be a fiscal conservative when it comes to spending tax dollars. I want to use tax dollars. Everything I can do, everything I will spend will be with public safety in mind.